Patagonia. A land of wild beauty and untamed landscapes. Spanning across Chile and Argentina, is home to towering mountains, sprawling glaciers, and vast open plains. Let's take a journey through Patagonia, from its rugged coastline to its towering peaks. Prepare to experience one of the world's last frontiers and discover the raw, wild beauty of Patagonia.
We're going for a 6-hour hike.
Nice.
And then we're taking the bus 3 hours back.
What's been your favorite part of the trip so far?
When Tannen was sitting on the rock and he was all in his like
his model
Vogue aesthetic.
He was having his model moment.
Yeah, and he was like flicking his hair and drinking his water, and I was like, kill it.
Welcome to Buenos Aires, the vibrant capital of Argentina. Here, tango and steak are as much part of the city as its streets and buildings. Let's take a journey through the heart of Buenos Aires and discover what makes this city so special. From the busy streets filled with colorful murals to the wide avenues lined with trees, Buenos Aires is a feast for the eyes. No trip to Buenos Aires would be complete without experiencing the passion and drama of the tango. The sensual dance that was born on the streets of Buenos Aires has now become a global phenomenon. And finally, when you need a break from the hustle and bustle of the city, Buenos Aires has plenty of green spaces to explore. From the peaceful Japanese gardens to the sprawling Palermo Park, there's no shortage of places to relax and recharge. So there you have it. Buenos Aires is a city that truly has it all: culture, food, music, and nature.
Soup.
Is it good?
Yes, and now look at our view. I mean, like, we are literally in this, like a movie.
In the heart of Patagonia lies a natural wonder that has captured the imagination of countless scientists. Agazzi-Morrone is one of the world's most magnificent glaciers. It is a vast expanse of ice that stretches over 30 kilometers in length and 5 kilometers in width. This colossal glacier is located in the Los Glaciers National Park, and is one of the few glaciers in the world that is still advancing. Its massive walls of ice reach heights of over 70 meters, towering over the surrounding landscape. The glacier's mesmerizing blue color is due to the way the ice reflects and refracts light, creating a breathtaking spectacle that must be seen to be believed.
We're at a ranch, and there's a bunch of animals on this ranch, and that's really cool. I want to go shoot it really badly.
Hi, my name is Gonzalo. Gonzalo de Musel, you can call me Gonza, and I am an astronomer here in Astroturismo. I don't know if you want to know about the stars here in the Southern Hemisphere, probably this is your tour. For example, the Southern Cross and the Milky Way Arm, we can see it from with our own naked eyes.
Do you have a favorite star?
Favorite star.
Very astronomical object.
Yeah,
or astronomical object. Omega Centauri. It's a star cluster with millions of stars. It's a little bit difficult for observers, but in astrophotography, it's really, really beautiful.
When we were looking at the stars, we saw a long line of stars. It's called Starlink. And we were talking about how it's actually super damaging to a lot of wildlife, like sea turtles. The way they find their way home and they lay their eggs, they use the stars. Almost, and it's so blinding that the animals can't. The sea turtles, they read. They're smart. They can find their way to lay their eggs back to their home using the stars as like their map. But because of Starlink, it's making it difficult, and they die. We're the first generation that don't know how to read the stars.
I saw a star cluster, and it was the prettiest thing I've ever seen in my entire life.
There were like a million stars.
It's beautiful.
It was the prettiest.
I don't even know you. If that's